Hello, folks. I hope that you guys are just having a great day today and keeping safe on this Saturday during our COVID crisis. Hey, I'm reaching out to you to talk to you about the next chapter in my Living with HD series, where I'm kind of a sequel to last week. Last week, I talked about what it's like to live as an adult at home, as somebody with Huntington's disease. This time, I want to talk a little bit more about what it's like to work, kind of the living single, working at home. What's it like to be a kind of adulting at work, if you will, and living at HD? So I'll talk about some of the things that happen, some of the challenges I encounter as somebody with Huntington's disease at work, as well as some of the things that I do to help overcome them. So that's the goal of today's channel. So today, let's go ahead and start. As a reminder, Huntington's disease is a genetic condition that I inherited from my mom. Other people have inherited it from their parents. It's a dominant gene. It's a 50-50 chance that you're going to give it to any given kid. And if they have it, they will have the condition. It is a neurological condition that affects the mind. It attacks three various aspects of a person. The first is their mental health. They're more likely to become depressed, suicidal, and other sort of issues like that. It also attacks their mind and their mental capacity. They're likely to forget things. Their IQ will drop. It'll attack them mentally. They'll forget things. And then finally, it'll attack them physically. They'll have twitches, pulses of their body, and will move back and forth. And that will increase, all three of those will increase as the condition goes on. It's different in everybody, and everybody's manifested has different sort of manifestations of those three different things at different rates during the run of the condition. And I'm 7 years into my Huntington's disease. It started when I was in my mid-30s, and I'm now 43. Turned 43 a couple months ago. Again, there's my quick reminders of what HD is. Now, when I'm at work, it does have a definite impact on my sort of work performance and such. I see it at work. For example, I have a tendency to forget something unless I've written it down. So I write things down more for work than I used to have to do. I used to just be able to remember stuff so easily for work. It used to be the case that when I first started as a professional in my mid, when I was 24, to even going through to my mid 30s. If my boss told me to do something, I would remember to do it. I didn't have to write it down. When I first started out, I didn't have to have a calendar at all. You know, I would just remember all of my dates, all of my appointments, especially main things that I had to do on a weekly, bi-weekly, or monthly basis, right? Those tasks. I would never have to set a reminder. I'd never have to put them in my calendar because I didn't have a calendar. And I never needed those sorts of things in order to be successful at my career. I never needed any of those things to do. And I was winning awards or being nominated for awards during my time too. For service, for working hard. I wasn't getting sanctioned by my bosses. I wasn't being fired, right? Nothing was happening, right? I wasn't having any major issues. But now today, if I want to remember the work tasks that I have to do, I have to keep a calendar. I've learned that I need to put a calendar, and I need to put calendar, not just meetings, not just things like that, but other people might put in their calendar. I even put tasks in my calendar, like what tasks do I need to do that day or today? I keep a running checklist by my desk, so that and a running piece of paper. So if something comes across my desk, my boss swings by the office and says, "Hey, I need you to do this, or make this a priority, please finish this by the end of the day." Or if I get an email, or have a conversation with a resident or their parents where I need to do something that day, I'll actually write it down on the checklist. I'll even prioritize things that don't have to be done that day for a couple of reasons. One, I think it's efficient. So if my boss comes in and says, "Hey, by the end of the week, I need you to do this and it's Tuesday," I'll actually just prioritize getting it done that day if I can, even though I don't need to. It's efficient. It makes so there's value in that. It's done. I don't have to worry about it. But also, I don't have to worry about forgetting about it either. So I also do that as one of those sort of tips of kind of dealing with that as an issue, is overcoming that. Finally, one of the things I like to do when it comes to helping out with those sorts of things is I actually color code my calendar as well. When it comes to using a calendar as a tool for helping dealing with HD. Not only will I write everything down, I prioritize getting things done as soon as possible, but I'll also color code my calendar. So I have personal work, different types of work, tasks are one color, meetings are another color, regular meetings, like my one-on-ones with my staff that I supervise or with my are also different colors too. So I have several different colors in my calendar, which helps me to see what I have to do that day. All these things help. They help me keep things from not going too far, at least yet. So for example, while I have sometimes forgotten things or the occasional meeting, something like that, I haven't been sanctioned in my 2.5 years at my job, which is more like two and three quarters now, actually, the last couple months, getting close to 3 years. I was hired for this job in August, 2.5 years ago. So getting close to August, actually, so in my almost 3 years of the job. So I've got been able to successfully do the job. I haven't been disciplined, I haven't been sanctioned, I've been fired, right, so forth. And that has happened at some of my previous jobs. you know, that's one of the things I'm learning how to do is how to work with this condition and what that's like. And I have to, you know, and what I need to do. I also color coordinate in addition to my my calendar. I also color coordinate my folders in my desk office. I try to be very organized with my desk office too. Again, if I know where things are, I'll know where to go. I have a receipts drawer. I will make sure, for example, I'll try to be as organized as possible. So for example, when I first started, I would just have a receipts folder, but now I tape receipts to a piece of paper and I write on the piece of paper like what that was receipt was for. So each receipt's on a tape on a piece of paper. That way I can keep it better, I can keep it more organized, I can find it quicker. I don't need to remember what the amount was, that sort of thing. I can just, you know, do it. Go and find it if I need to use my receipts to tally up, like how much I spent that month on a particular project or something like that. I can go do that. I don't have to, you know, be able to do that math on my head, so I can use a calculator instead. Those things have changed. But I try to be more organized, much more organized than I was. Because that's how I'm surviving in a work environment, is by being more organized, whether it's organization, color coordinating my folders. I have, for example, I supervise a number of seven student staff, and those student staff are hired in different years. Some of them working for 3 years, some two, some one. So I've color coordinated the folders based on what year they started with me. So I have different color coordinated folders for that purpose as one example of how I use it. I'll even use it for things like when I'm applying for a job, but that's probably for another session. That's going to be my next one. How to apply for jobs with HD is going to be my next section. I feel like it's a nice follow-up from working with HD. So that's going to be next week. But in the meantime, I'll go ahead and leave it to you there. Are there any tips that you use for HD or a similar condition or anything that you can think of that I'm not doing? Happy to engage you with that or any challenges that you're having at work, that sort of thing. You know, my goal is to kind of turn this aspect of this channel into a sort of an opportunity for tools for living, surviving, and thriving, hopefully, with HD, even now. So there you are. I'll go ahead and leave you to it. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please feel free to hit that subscribe button. I try to do a weekly each Saturday for you on what it's like to live with HD. And finally, I just want to thank you for taking some time out of your day. We all have so many things happening, and our lives are pulled in so many different directions. So the fact that you spent this time with me, that's very humbling. And I really do appreciate that. So thanks again and have a good one.